Kia ora koutou. Thank you so much for inviting myself and the Minister for Women to be here and share this short video message with you for this very special awards.
Closing the gender pay gap is a priority for the government. As many of you will know, New Zealand has a gender pay gap of 9.3%. But I should point out, that isn't evenly distributed across all women. Māori, Pacific, Asian, and disabled women often face significantly greater pay gaps. To help lead the way in closing the gender pay gap and the ethnic gender pay gap, it's really important that the public service lead by example. So last year, I challenged the public service to do just that, lead the way.
And now, as a result of agencies and unions working together, we have a comprehensive three-year action plan. The plan substantially accelerates work to eliminate the gender pay gap in the public sector and includes milestones and targets along the way. I'm pleased to say that we are making great progress. We're starting to see results. Two-thirds of public service agencies have closed any gender pay gaps within the same or similar roles. The rest will have completed this by the end of next year. 50% of public service CEs are women, and 15 agencies are piloting flexible work by default approaches.
We hope that by proving the public service can take concrete steps to remedy its gender pay gap across organizations that range in size from 30 employees to thousands of employees, other organizations will see that they can take action and see the value of these steps.
These awards are proof that public and private sector organizations are already doing impressive work in this area. And by working together, sharing best practice examples, and celebrating our wins, I'm certain that we can continue to make significant progress.
Tonight, we congratulate all of you here for your commitment to closing the gender pay gap and championing this cause. You are true leaders in Aotearoa New Zealand, and we wish you all the best on continuing the great work you are doing.
Ta alofa lava, tēnā koutou, nizam bolavinaka. Greetings, everyone. It's your friendly Equal Employment Opportunities Commissioner here at the Human Rights Commission. I am Saono Mali Karanina Sumio. I want to congratulate all the finalists and the winners for this year's events at the Equal Pay Awards. And also, I just want to congratulate the YWCA again for their continued leadership in this work. Equal pay. We know we've had an act for quite a long time, and it's not the experience of some of our populations. Some may say a significant number of our population. So equal pay is something we need to continue our efforts. It's great to see that we've made progress around the gender pay gap. We're not quite there yet, but we are making progress. I ask you all please now to consider looking at the other impacts on equal pay, considering the factors of ethnicity, around disability, and so therefore I'm thinking about our populations, including our recent settlers who may not be familiar with negotiations and so forth. And we're thinking about our people re-entering the workforce, including our older workers. So when we think about equal pay, I encourage you all to think much more broader now, beyond our gender pay gap, and consider pay transparency as a potential mechanism that we can use in New Zealand. With your support, you as businesses who are doing this, we call on your support for that campaign so that we can support equal pay going forward for all our people. All the best tonight and enjoy yourself. Soifua.